Hi, my name is Gaurish. Welcome to Salesforce Rangers. Today we are going to learn about Apex Collections. Okay, so I have opened the developer console and now I will open execute anonymous window. This execute anonymous window allows me to write any Apex code and execute it and see the results on the go. So I am just widening the window. So there are three types of collections: list, set and map. These three collections are very important, you know, while we are building our logic in Apex. So let's get to know them one by one. I will start with list. So list is an array. You should already know about what is an array. If I print my list in Apex, it is represented like this. So this is a list of string or an array of string. There can be multiple ways to declare a list. So I can declare a list like this. And I can declare my list or array like this. Now list have a method called add. So if I use my str list dot add and I add a string value, so you can see that I have added four string values in my str list. Now I'm going to debug this. Open log and execute. So we have an error. You can see that my list is represented like this only. So it starts with bracket, and similarly I can have my list of integer, int list. I can create list of decimal, list of list of date. So this is the data type. This defines, it tells us that what type of data this list or array contains. So we have created a string list, that's why we are having string values in our list. Now let's talk about this type of declaration. This line number 3 and line number 4, they are basically same, just the different way to represent a list. So as you can see that in this type of declaration, list declaration, when I use this, it was showing an error. If I click execute, it will show an error like this, an expected token. So I can do it like this. Now I can put some values here and debug this. You can see that the same representation is there. So conceptually it's one and the same thing. These both are same thing. You can use whatever way you like. Now there is another method called add all. We have learnt about add method. Now there is another method called add all. So what I'm going to do now is use it add all method. So add all method basically add one array or list into another list. So if I write str dot add all and I pass my str list into that, then it's going to copy all these four values, all these two values into all these two values. And let's try to debug this. You can see that str array, which was having these two values test and wake encode, now also has the four values which belong to the str list, and it now has six values in this list. So add all method is also, you know, quite important while writing the logic. Now we have a property called size. If I want to check size of the list, then we can write like this, and if I debug, it's going to return 6. You see, 6 is the size of this list. So we talked about add all size. So generally these methods are used, and list, so those who don't know this thing, list is basically a class in our Apex library. List is a class. So if I Google list class Apex and check out this link, then it's going to show me all the methods this class is having, and I will show you the methods which we have used in our demonstration. Yes. So list class contains methods for list collection type. Now the methods, we can see all the methods of list from here. Add is also having another type of method, add all, and clear, clone, contains method is used to check whether an element exists in this list or not. And you know, there are many more, sort, to string, size. So you will have to go through them one by one. It's a long list. So we have talked enough about list. Let's talk about set. So set is we can say it's quite similar with the list, but there is a main difference here. In our list, we can have duplicate elements. For example, if I open the previous debug log, you can see that there is wake encode two times. Now if I try to put these same values in my set, then it's going to override the existing one. So in our set, there cannot be any duplicate element. Now the set declaration is very similar, set of string, str set. Instead of list, we are just having the set here. Now as far as I know, set doesn't have any other interpretation like this list. Okay, I'm decreasing the font size. Now let's try to use add all method and use str. So now what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to copy str array into my set. which has duplicate values, of course. So let's see how our set reacts and what does it return. Let me put a debug on my set, str set. As you can see that there is no duplicate in this. There are 5 elements instead of 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And one more difference. You know, the list representation started with the normal brackets, but set is represented with the curly brackets. So let me remove the size from here and so list is represented like this with the normal brackets and set is starts with the curly brackets. So this may not be you know, some of you may not find it useful information, but yeah, it's good to know about it. Now let's try one more method on our set. Contains. True. So contains method is also common in list and set, and there is one method in list class which is called sort method. Sorts the items in the list in ascending order. Let's try this. So on my array, I'm going to put sort, execute. Arithmetic expressions are not allowed on void types. Okay, I think it returns something. So it's an arithmetic expression, so we cannot use it as a statement. Now I'm sorting it in another line and just trying to debug it right here. See, our list is now sorted. Earlier it was test, wake and code, then Gaurish, Mahesh, Abhinav and like that, but now it has alphabetically sorted this. Now let's try to sort our set. Let's see if it does it or if it actually sort our set or not, or maybe, you know, there may be a surprise that str set dot sort and execute it method does not exist. So in our set we cannot sort it. And you will be, some of you may have noticed already, but set already sorts everything inside it. So as you can see that in the debug log, it has already sorted the values in alphabetical order, in ascending order. Okay, so enough about list and set. Let's move to maps. I'm going to comment or maybe delete it. So map is very important and you may find it complex to learn it. You know, So a lot of practice you may need to require, you may need to have for maps. So map is basically a key value pair. Key and value. Now I cannot write it like this, key and value. We need to define the data type. What is going to be the data type of my key and what will be the data type of my value. So let's start with the simple one, string and string, or maybe integer. So like I told you that list is a class in the Apex library. Similarly, map is also a class and set is also a class, and you can find the methods of list, set, map in the Salesforce documentation. Now I'm going to put some key value pairs inside my map using the method put. So our first method in the map is put my map, which is the object of my map class. I will use the method name put, and it is a put method has two arguments. First one is the key, let's give it a, and the value is, we have defined it is of integer type, so we are going to put an integer here. Now I will put more key value pair like this, b for 2, and let's try to debug. We will see that how map is represented. We have already seen how list and set are represented. So here it is. It also starts with a curly bracket, and simply it contains the key value pair a equal to 1, b equal to 2, and so on. So the other method is get. Since we have put our key value pairs, now the key value pairs are in their place in my map. Now I am going to get the values by providing the key to my map. So I will use my map object, my map dot get, and suppose I want to know what is the value for C. So I will pass C as the key, and since I know that the value is of integer type, I have defined it right here. So it's going to return me an integer value. So I will have to create an integer variable here to store that value. And now I'm going to debug my integer variable. Identifier is reserved. Okay. So we cannot use int. Int is a reserved keyword. So I will use val. So C stands for 3, and similarly if I try to get the value of B, it will return me 2. So it sounds quite simple, but it's not like that, believe me. You know, we are using the primitive data types here, string and integer. It becomes complex when we start using the non-primitive data types like S objects. For example, ID, comma, account. This is a map which will return me a value of account type. Now, this is also quite easy, but the complication will arrive when the case is that my value is a list of account. So this is also simpler, but it gets more complicated when my value of the map is another map of another type, for example this. So you know, it's a nested map returning another map, and it may have another level of map as well to make it more complex. I'm not going to frighten you guys. We will get to know into the map details in different separate videos because it's a large topic and it needs a lot of practice to get a hold of map in Apex. So thank you for watching my video. That's all about the basics of Apex collections. Have a good day.